Hi friends, this is Prithvi. Welcome to Techie Taiki. Finally, I have purchased one Odroid C2 board. I know it got launched 2 plus years back and this is almost end of Jan 2019. In this video I will be discussing about some misconception on Odroid. Stay tuned. So I have purchased Odroid C2 board and the official Odroid case for Odroid C2. Let me open it up quickly. So Odroid is made in Korea. It's from a South Korean company. So some paperwork. So here is the board. Written made in Korea. So in terms of size, it is of same size like Raspberry Pi 3 and 3B plus. If you see USB ports, LAN and other things like HDMI, all other things are in the same position also. So this is a jumper. We have to keep the jumper on. Left to that we have a micro USB port. We can use this to power up the device. This is one misconception which I was talking about. I'll come and explain in detail later on. We can remove the jumper and use for some other purpose. I'll come to that later. So we have the processor and two RAMs below the heat sinks. These are the 40 GPIO pins. And the remote sensor. So there are total 4 RAMs on this board, 2 below the heatsink and 2 backside. So we have 1.5 GHz quad core processor, ARM Logic ARM Cortex A53. Backside we have the EMC module and micro USB port. We can see 2 RAMs are there. So this side we have GB LAN and 4 USB 2.0 port. So this is the Odroid C2 official case. It's all concealed. Every time I cannot take the board out to change the SD card, so I have to break that part. Backside to take out the SD card. So I have put the Odroid C2 in Raspberry Pi 3. B official case. It is fitting but not 100%. Little bit of misplacement is happening due to the clips on the back side of the board. So I have downloaded Android Marshmallow version 4.9 from Odroid site. It is already downloaded. I'll flash it on SD card with HR and once it boots up, I'll show you the user interface and I'll try play some tough games, PlayStation games, to show you the performance. So I am flashing the image now on micro SD card. So I waited for so long to buy Odroid C2 or any other Odroid boards due to its shipping methods, because Odroid generally like ship all the items with either DHL, FedEx and all expensive logistic partners. Like they should adopt some affordable way of sending the items. So that is also holded me back buying the Odroid products. So now let's talk about the misconception which I was talking about. So Odroid boards are not expensive. Like yes, some boards are expensive but not all. Like it becomes expensive due to like its costly shipping methods, and there are local distributors. Like at least in my country, apart from the item cost, they keep their margin in terms of the international shipping cost also. But I'm sure there must be like purchasing the items in bulk, so they should do little bit of concession on that part, but that never happens. In that case, I think Odroid should step in and try bringing some affordable shipping solution. So that will also increase their product sales. But in most of the YouTube videos, I keep hearing this like Odroid boots are expensive. Yeah, it becomes expensive with the shipping cost and other cost in terms when it ends up in your country, like maybe the other expenses in terms of customs will be included, so it goes up. But if you see and compare, the boats are not that expensive. It is at par, at least if you compare Odroid C2 only, it at par with Raspberry Pi. Now the second important thing which I would like to highlight again, like these are not new things. People who are familiar with Odroid C2, these are not for them. So which I have noticed, I have seen a lot of videos on YouTube where people keep saying that Odroid boards you always have to use their products in terms of the power adapter also, as it uses barrel type charger, power adapter, 2.5 mm. But this is not the case. At the beginning of of my video, like I have shown, like on the board, like the micro USB port can be used to power up the device. Like we have just to make sure that the jumper is on. Like you can use the micro USB for powering the device by putting the jumper on. You can remove it to use it as a micro USB to transfer data, like as a OTG data transfer. Like again, you can remove it to use it for using the barrel type charge power adapter also. So right now I'm using my normal mobile charger adapter, like 5 volt 2 ampere, which I generally use to power up all the Raspberry Pi ASUS Thinkerboard. So it is working absolutely fine. There is no issue at all. So I just wanted to clarify and share my experience on that. So Acer is still flashing. So once it is done, I'll see you on the boot screen. So Android Marshmallow is booting up on Odroid C2. This is the first boot. Odroid C2 is a very powerful device compared to Raspberry Pi 3 and 3B Plus. It got 2 GB RAM and the processor is also like faster. It's a 1.5 GHz one. So compared to Raspberry Pi 3B Plus also, it's good. Like in terms of performance, it will be really good. The only disadvantage on this board is like it doesn't have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth inbuilt, and the Wi-Fi adapter that I have, it's not working on this device. Just wanted to show that this is working on Android Marshmallow. As my current Wi-Fi adapter is not working on this device, so I have downloaded PPSSPP emulator APK file and inserted it through my Toshiba pen drive. So the file management system is here, Cyanogen. So you can see this is the APK file. So I'll install it now and do some minor changes from PPSSP emulator from the setting part, just to make sure all games run smoothly. Even if you don't change, it will run, but there will be little bit of glitch and audio will be little choppy. And some games, as I said, like I will be playing all the tough games, PPSSP games, tough games, sorry, PlayStation games. So it may have some problem, but to be on safer side, I'm just putting the
frame skip to 2, and I'll keep the auto frame skip to 2. So the video quality will deteriorate a little bit, not much.
I have transferred 4 PlayStation games via pen drive to the internal memory. In the SD card, I put the games. So I'll be playing Tekken 6. This is a very hard game for single board computers to manage, but I'm sure Odroid will be able to manage it efficiently.
Get ready for the next night. Round 1. Fight. Round 2. Fight. Perfect. You win.
Oh, yeah.
Get ready for the next battle. Round 1. Fight. Round 2.
I'll be testing Ridge Racer 2 now. This is a very hard game for single board computers. In my last video, I have played this game on Asus ThinkerBoard, switching off the auto frame skip on, and Asus ThinkerBoard was not able to manage this game. It was not playable at all.
Proceed with above choices. Please select a course. Please select a machine class. Tamper, bayonet. Get ready to race.
Are you nervous? I'm so excited! Come on! Hurry up and start the race! Three, two, one, go! Three laps to go! dead last. Are you nervous? I'm so excited! Come on! Hurry up and start the race! Three, two...
I don't think I need to say much. This is playing really well.
Starting Ridge Racer. Proceed with above choices. Please select a machine class. Please select a course. Please select a machine class. Arthaluto, Futterin. Get ready to race.
Are you nervous? I'm so excited! Come on! Hurry up and start the race! Three laps to go! Okay, let's go! Unbelievable!
I must say I'm really enjoying Odroid. That's it in today's video, guys, and I hope you have liked this. If you like, please like, share and subscribe. I will also request you to check my playlist. There are other videos on different single board computers. Please go and watch. If you like, please like those videos also. Share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.